Hello everyone, today we are going to start new chapter, agriculture, chapter 4, part 1. In this part, we will see Indian agriculture, introduction about it. Then, main features of Indian agriculture. After one, types of farming in India. Then, cropping pattern. In India means agricultural seasons. After that we will see types of agricultural products. Agriculture in India is a very important economic activity since ancient time. At present, India ranks at second position in world in farm output. Agriculture plays very important role in contribution of India's GDP. GDP, gross domestic product. Although its contribution in GDP is steadily declining with the overall country's economic growth, still it is the largest economic sector and plays a significant role in overall socio-economic development of India. India is one among the largest exporters of agricultural products. Now we will see main features of Indian agriculture. The main features of Indian agriculture are, number one, it is the main source of livelihood. Largest percentage of the workforce of India is engaged in agriculture or the other activity related to agriculture. Second, Indian agriculture is mainly dependent on monsoon. So its dependencies on monsoon is one of the important feature. Most of the farmers depend on monsoon to cultivate the crops. If monsoon fails, crops fails. If monsoon is good, then farmers produce a good amount of crop. Third, Indian agriculture is labor intensive cultivation, means most of the cultivation work, agricultural work, is done with the help of manual labor. Next, under employment means agriculture is done according to season. So when they do cultivation, they do it, but afterward they remain unemployed. Or what number of labor is needed to do cultivation more than that work in same piece of land. Next feature of Indian agriculture is its land holding, size of land holdings. The land holdings are very small due to law of inheritance. The size of land holdings are getting smaller and smaller. Next feature of Indian agriculture is traditional method of production. Most of the agricultural work is done by old techniques, old method. Traditional methods are applied. Then, low agricultural production. As the old techniques or methods are applied, so production is also very low. And last but not least, dominance of food crops, means most of the farmers are engaged in production of food crops, which is subsistence type, means only for survival purpose, not for selling purpose, not for developmental purpose. So these are the main features of Indian agriculture. Now we will see types of farming practiced in India. Mainly the types of farming which are practiced in India are subsistence type. Subsistence type have two types: primitive subsistence farming and intensive subsistence farming and commercial farming. Primitive subsistence farming, it is also called slash and burn farming, in which land is obtained by clearing forest. Agriculture is practiced till fertility of land is exhausted, or mainly women work on fields. It is practiced by primitive tribes living in forest in India, Northeast India, Odisha, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and parts of Madhya Pradesh. This type of agriculture is practiced, and the main crops which are grown yam, root crops. Slash and burn cultivation is known by different names in India as well as in the world. See, northeastern states, it is known as jhooming. In Manipur, Pamla, Chhattisgarh, Dipa, Andaman and Nicobar, also Dipa, Madhya Pradesh, Bewa or Dahia, Andhra Pradesh, Podu or Penda, Odisha, Koman or Bringa, Western Ghats, it is known as Kumari. In Rajasthan, it is called Vellore or Veltur. In Himalayan belt, it is called Khil, as well as in Jharkhand, it is called Gurua. While in world, it is known as Mexico. In Mexico and Central America, it is called Milpa. In Venezuela, in South America, it is called Conuco. In Brazil, it is called Roca. In Central Africa, it is called Mesole. In Indonesia, it is known as Ladang. And Vietnam, it is called Re. Most of these countries are located near equator. So the area where hot and wet climate is found, dense evergreen forest exists. In dense forested area, this type of agriculture is practiced, slash and burn cultivation. Next type of farming is intensive subsistence farming, which is practiced over a larger part of India. See the main features of intensive subsistence type farming. It is practiced in areas of high population pressure on land, means it is practiced in densely populated area. Second, the labor intensive farming, means work is done with the help of manual labor. Biochemical fertilizers and pesticides are used to protect the crop or to increase the production. Next, irrigation used for water supply. Irrigation is done in it. While in primitive subsistence farming, irrigation is not done. Farmers are dependent on rain. Next, due to this type of method applied in this agriculture, high production, the yield is high, means farmers produces high amount of crops. Then third type of farming is commercial farming, farming which is done for selling purpose, in which high yielding varieties of seeds are used, HYB, chemical fertilizers, insecticide and pesticides to increase the production are applied, or this type of agriculture is practiced in Haryana and Punjab. Commercial farming is further of two types. One, grain farming, and another is called plantation farming. In grain farming, as we saw, high doses of modern input like HYV, seeds, chemical fertilizers, insecticide, pesticides are used to increase the production. Degree of commercialization of agriculture changes from one region to another depending on the geographical condition of the area. Plantation is also a type of commercial farming where a single crop is grown over a large area. All the produce used as raw material in industries. In plantation farming, the produce is used as a raw material for industries. In India, the main crops which are grown through plantation farming are tea, coffee, rubber, sugarcane, banana. Tea in Assam and North Bengal, coffee in Karnataka are some important plantation crops grown in these states. As the production is mainly for market, a well-developed network of transport and communication connecting the plantation areas, processing industries and market plays a very important role in the development of this plantation farming. So now we will see difference between subsistence farming and commercial farming. In subsistence farming, farming done for own consumption, while in commercial farming, produce is sold to the market for earning purpose. In subsistence farming, entire production used by farmers and his family, while farmers use inputs like irrigation, chemical fertilizers, insecticide, etc. to increase the production. While in subsistence farming, land holdings are small and fragmented, means get smaller and smaller due to law of inheritance. Cultivation methods are old and simple, while in this, modern methods are applied. Crops grown are mostly cereals, oilseeds, pulses, vegetables, sugarcane, while in this the crops grown cotton, jute, sugarcane, groundnut. But in Haryana, rice is cultivated in subsistence farming. But in Haryana, Punjab, rice is cultivated for commercial purpose. So in Eastern India, means Bihar, West Bengal, Odisha, Assam, rice is a food crop. Come in subsistence farming, but same product, rice in Punjab, Haryana, means in Western India, is a commercial crop. See, in subsistence farming, land holdings are small. Most of the work done by manual labor or by using animals. Now we will see cropping patterns in India, means agricultural seasons. So based on seasons in which crops are grown, there are three types of crops. Some crops are called kharif crop, also called monsoon crop. Some crops are called jayat crops, also called summer crops. And some crops are cultivated during winter season called winter crops or rabi crops. Kharif crops means monsoon crops are cultivated, are sown with the arrival of monsoon, means in the month of June. Monsoon arrives in the month of June and harvested with the withdrawal of monsoon, means in the month of October. Jayat crop, planted in March and harvested in June for very shorter period of time. And rabi crop is planted in the month of November and harvested in the month of April. See, which are the kharif crops? Rice, maize, cotton, groundnut. These are kharif crops, while jayad crop, watermelon, cucumber means vegetables mainly which grow for in very short period of time, and rabi crops, wheat, barley, pea, gram. So these are some of the examples of crops grown in different seasons. On the basis of the nature of use of the agricultural products, the agricultural products are classified into following group. Number one, food grains, crops that are used for human consumption. Which crops come under this? Rice, wheat, maize, millets, pulses, and oilseeds. All these are food crops. Commercial crops, crops which are grown for sale either raw form, means for industries, or in semi-processed form. Cotton, jute, sugarcane, tobacco, and oilseeds. Plantation crops, crops which are grown on plantation covering large estates, means all the processing units are also located within the, means final product, after processing, final product is sent to market. So which comes under this? Tea, coffee, coconut, and rubber. Then come horticulture, sections of agriculture in which fruits and vegetables are grown. Fruits, vegetables are cultivated in horticulture. So that's all for today. Thank you.